With ongoing conflicts in Syria and Iraq and complicated situations in Egypt and Libya, what should the U.S. role be in foreign conflicts?
We need the strongest and most technologically advanced military in the world, bar none. That's no question about that. But we've made mistakes in Iraq and Afghanistan, and we should learn from them. To defend America, first of all, if we're going to go to war, number one, Congress needs to vote on that under Article 1, Section 8 of the Constitution. Number two, U.S. national security needs to be at stake. And number three, we need a plan to win any war that we might engage in and exit. We have not done that in Iraq and Afghanistan. And Jean Shaheen's vote for a Syria bombing war last year, reckless, haphazard foreign policy, it would not improve U.S. national security. It would stick us in another military quagmire in the Middle East. It would force us to put boots on the ground, and American national security would not be enhanced. We need to be more thoughtful, and we need to have a long-term strategy to preserve world peace, and it does not involve America going to war in every single case.
Well, our foreign policy, our allies don't trust us, our enemies don't fear or respect us, and I think that's a lack of leadership by the president when he said, we're going to draw a red line. If you cross that line, watch out. Well, they crossed the red line, they tore up the red line, they changed colors of the red line, and here we are, we did nothing. And when you see what's happening not only in Ukraine with Crimea, you look at what's happening in Syria, you look at Afghanistan, Iraq. In October 11, I wrote a letter to the then to Chairman Levin, Armed Services, saying, please don't leave Iraq as is, leave all those battles on, you know, all those victories on the ground, on the battlefield. And because we need a transition force, a training force, a reactionary force to help guide in that government. We did nothing, and we left, and there's a vacuum. Once again, Senator Shaheen, as a member of the Foreign Relations Committee, has backstopped and approved every single initiative that the president has put forth, and those policies, I would argue, have failed. We need strong leadership. We need to reestablish the trust with our allies, and we need to reestablish the fear and respect by our foes as well.
This is religious, cultural, and tribal warfare. It's been going on since Muhammad died, which I believe was 632 AD. So how many centuries is that? 16, 17, 18 centuries these conflicts have been going on. So we can't win those wars with our hands. I've talked to troops who have been going to Afghanistan or coming home or going to the Middle East somewhere, Iraq or someplace else, and coming home over the years, and they tell me the same thing. The rules of engagement are terrible. Their hands are tied behind their backs. They can't fire until fired upon. The politicians are trying to fight the war where you need to let the soldiers fight the war. And I think the last point is the reason why we need to get out. I want to stress it, out. We need to get out there, out of there, because we cannot nation build. You cannot plant seeds of democracy in a country that doesn't want it, that doesn't have the tradition or the values for it.
Read more about where the candidates stand at WMUR.com.